Vaughn, and today I'm going to be showing you guys yet another holiday hairstyle idea. So before we get started, we have to clean this dirty hair. I'm going to be using a clarifying shampoo from the Shea Moisture Jamaican Black Castor Oil line called the Strengthen, Growth, and Restore Shampoo. This shampoo is great for color-treated or heat-style hair, and today we're dealing with both. My hair is newly colored, so I'm doing everything I can to preserve the vibrancy of the color and also to maintain moisture. It's important that my hair stays clean, especially my scalp, but I want to avoid any sort of harmful, harsh detergents like sulfates. My hair feels nice and clean and soft and ready for the next phase of the style. I love deep conditioning my hair. This one is a treatment mask by Shea Moisture from the Jamaican Black Castor Oil line. I love this deep treatment because it's so thick and waxy, it really, really coats the hair, and it really gives you that sort of deep penetration that you need. I like to lay this product on pretty thick from the tips all the way up to the root. I don't apply it directly to my scalp, but I do get pretty close. For today's treatment, I'm just going to finger comb and twist. I'm going to detangle later. Once I've thoroughly rinsed out the deep treatment mask, I then like to apply a moisturizer and heat protectant. This one does both. It's the Styling Lotion by Shea Moisture. It's from the Jamaican Black Castor Oil line as well. I like to apply this product to the hair in sections with hopes that it will penetrate the hair, kind of soak in for a little while. I like to go ahead and detangle, twist. That way the hair can sit and dry a little bit because I do not like blow drying my hair when it is soaking wet. I don't usually care at all. I let the hair dry in the meantime. I'll just go have lunch, you know, a little Alfredo pasta, you know what I'm saying? So after about 20 minutes, the hair is a little less damp, so I use my wide tooth comb to go ahead and start the blow drying process. Once I'm done blow drying the hair, I'm going to create my side part. Next, I'm going to separate the hair into large sections. This is optional, you don't have to do it, but this helps me tremendously. It's like a guide for where each curl should fall. For today's look, I'm going to be using the Remington Curl Wand, the one with the very narrow barrel. I'm going to be using 380 degrees of heat. Using the curl wand is simple. You're just going to wrap the hair around the barrel and then hold it there until the curl is set. Then you're going to release by pulling up gently and letting the curl fall naturally. You could definitely achieve a similar curl with a twist out, but if you want more uniform curls, I would highly recommend the curl wand. For short to medium length hair, I would recommend starting your winding curls from the middle of the barrel and then working your way down. For longer hair, I would recommend starting at the top. If you have thermal gloves, use them. I could not find mine. When I was done with all the curls, I used a spritz spray with the intention to go back and separate them later. So, we're done with the hair. We're going to go ahead and let that set while we move on to makeup. On a clean face, I'm going to apply the Shea Moisture Healthy Glow Essentials Misting Toner. I recommend a cotton swab so you don't get it in your eye, but you will be surprised the stuff that a toner can remove from your skin. Next, I'm going to apply the Coconut and Hibiscus Spot Correcting Serum. This is perfect for applying under eye and in any dark areas of your face. I like to rub any excess product on my neck. I'm going to seal in all this goodness with my favorite moisturizer at the moment, my African Black Soap Problem Skin Moisturizer. I absolutely love the creamy texture of this moisturizer. You only need a small dab because it spreads very thin. After the moisturizer, you should always be priming your skin before you apply any makeup to it. I always focus my primer in the T-zone. Be sure that you shake your Shea Moisture Sheer Foundation before you use it, because it does have a tendency to settle. Using a flat brush, I'm going to rub this foundation all over my face. It feels like I'm putting on lotion. For my brows, I'm just going to brush them down, fill them in, and then set them with a highlighted brow set. I do this so that my brows can match my new bronze copper hair color. I'm priming my eyelids for this really beautiful angelic holiday eyeshadow that I'm going to show you guys today. I'm sweeping a medium brown into the crease, but then I'm going to go in with a more precise brush and apply some of the Casablanca Copper. This is going to define the lid a little more. And now for the star of the show, a beautiful holiday eyeshadow called Montana. This is more of a satiny eyeshadow with a very glittery finish. I'm going to apply this directly to the lid of my eye, not going beyond the crease. To really define that outer V, I'm going to use a little bit of black eyeshadow. I am not exaggerating, this is a very easy look to pull off. I'm finishing off the eyes with eyeliner and false lashes. Concealer is my favorite thing to use, so I'm actually going to use the Color Corrective System in Medium Light by Shea Moisture. It's so easy to see the difference. And I don't just apply concealer to my under eye. Anywhere where there's discoloration, whether it's a pimple, scar, or redness, or anything. The key to a flawless concealer application is blending. I like to use my beauty blender because it mimics natural skin texture. To set my overall liquid sheer foundation, I'm going to use the Shea Moisture Wet or Dry Powder. If you ever wonder how some women have such a flawless finish with their makeup, it's their setting powder. Just to get those dreamy eyes, I'm going to add a little bit more of the Casablanca Copper to the lower lash line. For my cheeks, I'm going to use this rosy cream blush. It's so beautiful and it looks so natural. I usually just use my fingers to apply this, and I'll pat it until it's perfectly blended. And since my eyes are so intense, I'm going to do more of a nude lip. So I'm applying some brown lip liner and a nude lipstick. And here's a tip, guys. Get a fluffy brush and use some of that Montana eyeshadow as a highlighter bronzer. This stuff picks up the light so well. It's absolutely beautiful. Now that we're done with the makeup, we can get back to the hair. Using the tail end of my wide tooth comb, I'm just going to separate some of those curls very carefully just to get a little more body. You can also choose to pick the hair from the root. That moment when you realize that your hair turned out exactly the way you wanted it. Once you get the desired fullness, I would highly recommend using a little more hairspray or spritz just to set it. This hairstyling technique can be used on all different hair textures, relaxers, and even extensions. And last but not least, we're going to give our edges a little love. I'm going to go ahead and touch them up with this edge treatment. This product is very jiggly and moisturizing. It kind of reminds me of flaxseed gel. Now you know this tutorial is nowhere near done until we've seen my finished look. Two very sexy looks to show you guys today. This first one is a classic black dress. I chose to pair it with these pointy toe strappy black pumps. The gold accessories surely bring attention to the eyeshadow. This next look is the same exact dress in mustard. I totally purposely matched my eyeshadow with my shoes. You can do that, you know. A cute little simple black clutch, and you are on your way to the holiday party. I really hope you guys enjoyed today's tutorial. How would you like to be one of three winners of every hair product featured in today's video? All you have to do is comment below on this video and tell us how you will be a better you in the new year. Are you going vegan? Going natural? Are you saving more money? Helping others? Let us know how you plan to improve yourself in the comments below. Three lucky winners will be chosen and announced on December 22nd. This is just my and Shea Moisture's way of wishing you a Merry Christmas. A special thanks to Shea Moisture for sponsoring this giveaway.